Kate Crowley from Teachers College, Columbia University in New York City. Welcome to Cleft Palate Speech and Feeding video tutorials with my co-authors, Dr. Miriam Baigorri and Chelsea Sommer. We've created this series of video tutorials on cleft palate speech and feeding. This is module 2.2, where we talk about resonance.
So everyone has their own type of resonance. Some people have a very big type of resonance, and some people have a very small type of resonance, depending on the shape of their oral cavity. Those who have cleft palate or may have a fistula have a lot of air escaping up to their nasal cavity. Therefore, they may display hypernasality, which may sound a little bit like this. Other children may display hyponasality, and this can also be when you have a cold and you may sound a little stuffy. The M's and N's, which are the nasal sounds, may become oral sounds, such as my mommy hummel. There's also another type of resonance known as cul-de-sac resonance, and this can be a shift in resonance or a decrease in nasal air emissions when the nose is occluded. This is also known as a potato in the mouth. So for hypernasality, there are some specific characteristics. There can be too much sound resonating in the nasal cavity during speech. This is usually due to velopharyngeal insufficiency or incompetency or due to an oral nasal fistula. Voiced or oral consonants become nasalized. So B's become M's and D's become N's and G's such as G become M, which is an obligatory distortion. Other phoneme-specific consonants may be substituted by nasals. So this sound may sound like an M. Severity depends on the size of the opening, the etiology, and even articulation. Sometimes in hyponasality, the nasal sounds end up sounding similar to their oral cognates. The M sound, M, becomes a B, the N sound, N, becomes a D, and the ng sound becomes a G. These are also noted on some vowels. Hyponasality characteristics may be present in apraxia of speech in that the velum does not lower fast enough for nasal phonemes once it has been raised for the oral sounds.
Do it today for Dad.
Do it today for Dad. Do it today for Dad.
A cookie or a cake?
A cookie or a cake. A cookie or a cake.
Now I'd like you to count from 1 to 10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Good. Do it again.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Good.
So how to distinguish hypernasality from hyponasality? You can do the Kummer test. So if an M sounds like a B, it is hyponasality, as in my mommy makes milk, for my mommy makes milk. If the B sounds like an M, it is hypernasality, as in my mammy a mine, for buy baby a bike. We can also see mixed resonance, and this is hypernasality and hyponasality, and they can occur together. This can occur when there is velopharyngeal dysfunction and a significant nasal airway or nasal cavity blockage. Hypernasality is present when producing oral sounds, but hyponasality is present during production of nasal sounds. So another type of resonance is oral cul-de-sac. This occurs when transmission of acoustical energy is trapped in a blind pouch with an entrance, but there's no outlet. This is known as potato in the mouth, or the sound is trapped in a cavity. This can happen with microstomia, which is a very small opening, like mumbling, so not opening your mouth wide enough. This can only be resolved through surgery. You can stimulate this type of resonance by speaking with a very small mouth opening.
It's not hyponasality. And it's not hypernasality. What is oral cul-de-sac?
That concludes module 2, where we looked at how speech sounds are made and how resonance is affected by cleft palate. For more information, please go to leadersproject.org, where this module and all other modules in this module series are available.